Hello everybody, welcome to my channel SN Zoology. First of all, I would like to thank all to like and subscribe my channel. So today's topic is your OA surveys. Sorry. As my students promise, they want to know what is OA surveys. So you all are very familiar to that point of that topic COA surveys, and that term you are always using your COA survey term that way in the form of your very beginning or the precipitation or the precursor slide. COA surveys is not very difficult term, it is very easy term, but you are using its many types of terms in your day to day life. But in our biology, or basically in zoology, COA surveys is a term which brings the precursion like what? So what is COA surveys? First of all, going to the topic COA surveys, I would like to give you some hints about origin of our life, how the living being originates, how it originates, why it originates, and for what it originates. So origin of life in the earth surface. So you all are basically knows what is the origin of life, but there is some clues which are hidden behind us that we are not know that about origin of life. I'm just telling you that origin of life is just a story. It is not real. It is a story, and we have found just piece of the story. When we have find all the pieces of that story, it will be completed, and we will get all the clues about the origin of life. So don't be made very seriously that it's only a story. So origin of life. About this origin of life, many scientists, many experts are giving their hypothesis about this origin of life, and various types of hypothesis like Oparin's hypothesis, Haldane hypothesis, and your Frondi-Fox hypothesis, Sidney-Fox hypothesis, and your Urey-Miller's hypothesis. But including all the hypotheses, we are getting just both two hypotheses only: abiogenesis and biogenesis. These are the most common theory, hypothesis or knowledge we are just studying in our life. So what is abiogenesis and what is biogenesis? Both are terms, biogenesis and abiogenesis. So what is both are biogenesis, abiogenesis? Let's discuss about biogenesis first. We can divide the biogenesis one two terms. One is bio, another is genesis. You all know that genesis is the term which makes a new form, that synthesis or producing something new. Synthesis or producing something new, that is genesis, you all know. And bio means when the term bio arising to your mind, when you listening the word bio, just only single term coming to your mind, that is living. What is living? Living already related to your bio. So when you indicating the term bio, only living word coming to your mind, that is living. And when living word coming to your mind, you also indicating that yourself. When living word coming, that you are already thinking about cell, because cell is the first living thing on the earth surface. That means what is cell? It is the structural and functional unity of a living body or living rock. What is structural or functional unity of which cell? So I am just told a cell ko paduche. So I am bhabuche living katha. Then living ko palla bade bhabujanti bio katha. So all are both cell, living and bio are only one thing. That means the living. So biogenesis indicate that living synthesis. That means two terms, bio and genesis. So bio indicates living, and genesis indicates your synthesis or production. So biogenesis your term that indicate that your living synthesis. biogenesis is a process according to many hypotheses of many scientists. Biogenesis is a process from which your life means it's living. So living are producing from only living things. Living are producing from your living things. That is biogenesis. The biogenesis is a process where the living beings are. We are just arising from living beings. Only living cells can find from or can produce from your living things. This is biogenesis. And what is abiogenesis? Abiogenesis. Biogenesis and you before you just cutting that A, which means pseudo or false. That means pseudo biogenesis or false biogenesis. That it is not a biogenesis process. So abio and genesis. Genesis means your formation or your synthesis. Abio means it's not bio. So abiogenesis is a process according to hypothesis. Abiogenesis is a process where living cells formed or synthesized from the non-livings. Non-livings. So these both the processes are different from each other. That is biogenesis, where livings are arising from the living things, and in the abiogenesis, livings are arising from the non-livings. So both the processes are coming from the hypothesis of our origin of life from different experts or environmentalists. So what is co-occurrence? Our topic is co-occurrence, not biogenesis or not abiogenesis. So before going to co-occurrence, so you have to know about abiogenesis and your biogenesis. So just leave the biogenesis process, just talk about abiogenesis. So abiogenesis is the process where non-living shark gives rise to livings or living things as arising from your non-living. So in the abiogenesis process, many scientists giving put forward their hypothesis like your Oparin concept, Haldane hypothesis, like your Fox hypothesis, Sidney Fox hypothesis, and Uri Miller's. A variety of scientists are giving variety of opinions. So, according to their hypothesis, in the abiogenesis process, you know, abiogenesis to biogenesis, it's a journey. Origin of life is only a journey from abiogenesis to biogenesis. In the middle position, what happened? In that position, biogenesis is the formation of living cell. Abiogenesis is the non-living. So, in the middle position, what happened? So, in the middle position, something hidden, we are not know it. So, in the abiogenesis process, many scientists give their hypothesis that they said that the life originates from a bubble drop, like a bubble drop, not water drop. It is a bubble drop like water. So, life firstly originates in the aqueous environment or the water environment. So, first of all, we know that bubble drop, all the on the basis of abiogenesis process, the bubble drop or bubble hypothesis is also a hypothesis which goes under the abiogenesis law. So bubble drop or bubble hypothesis, just we are going to read about what is bubble hypothesis. Bubble hypothesis is nothing. It's just like scientists said that bubble drop like substances which are arising to our earth, and from that bubble drop our life is just begin. So according to the scientists, many scientists, they said that life is begins from like bubble drop substances, and these are also some are called it protocells. Some are said just protobions. Some also said that microdrops. And also some said that co-occurrence. So here we just found the term co-occurrence. That is nothing. It's another name of protocells, protobions, microdrops or co-occurrence. But the co-occurrence, the term which was derived by the scientist Oparin, Alexander Oparin. So some are said it protocell, some are said it prebiotics, some are said it microdrops, and some are only Alexander Oparin derived the term, that is Cova cervus. It is related term of all are the same terms, related terms, but the term Cova cervus first derived by Alexander Oparin, I think it's in 1936, but not sure, so probably 1936. So according to Oparin concept, the Cova cervus is just a colloidal inclusion in the aqueous environment. As I said, life arising fast in the aqueous environment. So Oparin said that Cova cervus only arise in the aqueous environment. Cova cervus found in first aqueous environment. Your aqueous environment. As it found in aqueous environment, it's like a bubble drop, like water drop, not particularly water drop. It's like a bubble drop found in the water, like this. And these are very colloidal inclusions. So these Cova cervus look like a sphere ball, like spherical structure. You know, Cova cervus are always calling that it's the primitive cells. It's another name is your. You just call it your primitive cells because it is not a cell. It has no life. It is a non-living. But we have said it the primitive cell because it has some similarities to our living cell, like structure or function. So let's talk about your Cova cervus. So Cova cervus is like spherical in structure, had two layers. It's not now mentioned. Had two layers, which are made up of your lipid. So there are two lipid layers. As it mentioned that it is made up of two lipid layers, but you don't think that it's a plasma membrane, because living cell also plasma membrane also made up of your lipid. But it's not your plasma membrane. It is not a living cell. It's only your membrane is made up of your lipid layers. And another thing, why we relate it to cells, like your plasma membrane, just like your microdrops or micro molecules can move, passes through the plasma membrane, like this plasma membrane, micromolecules, any organic molecule can pass through that lipid layers of the wall. And also here inside it, you can just find organic molecules. Because organic molecules can pass through it, you can find your organic molecules, and just they pass through it, they can move back to it, and straps to it, many organic molecules straps, yeah, including to inside it, and always move it also. So when the organic molecules enter to the inside of the your Cova cervus, then what will happen? Organic molecules will be bombarded there, and they make the chemical functions inside it. So due to the chemical reactions, these organic molecules are just moving or increasing number. So the size of your Cova cervus increases, that the Cova cervus growth in size. Due to the growth of it, due to thermodynamically it's unstable because it's in aqueous your environment, it is thermodynamically unstable, and your organic substance also inside it. So the Cova cervus splits and the forms two daughter Cova cervus. So here we also found the properties of a living cell, that means the cell reproduces and forms two living cells. So here, as was your Cova cervus divides and forms two daughter cells. So we just make it out like your living cells. So this is your Cova cervus, and here inside it chemical substances arises and chemical functions or chemical reactions occur, and then growth in size and then split into two or many daughter coacervids. Or from that coacervids our living cell just arise according to Oparin. But according to another scientist Sydney Fox, according to Sydney Fox, the outer membrane of the coacervids just made up of a protein, and that protein substances can vary, and organic molecules can enter it or it splits into daughter coacervids. Many scientists said that the plasma, the membrane of your coacervids is made up also polysaccharides. Oparin said that lipids are layers, and Halil Sydney Fox said that it's your protein substances, and many scientists also said that it's also made up of your layer is polysaccharide. So it's your coacervids, but the two hypotheses were rejected because of just arising of your RNA. You also know RNA, ribonucleic acid. As you are biology student, you all are know what is RNA. It's the first genetic material and it's the first nucleic acid. When the RNA getting started or formation started, then two hypotheses gonna wrong, because from that RNA just living cells or genetic material are started. So as students, I'm just saying you, it's just a story like substance, and we have just a pieces of that story. When all the pieces we can find, then you can make that pursue that your origin of life. You see what is the thing, how is your origin, and we all got all the theories. So students, this was for you your coacervids. So thank you, like, subscribe and share my channel. Thank you.